Hey guys, it's Mark here from editorskeys.com, and today I'm going to show you how to record a perfect voiceover into Adobe Premiere Pro CC. In this step-by-step guide, I'll show you how to easily record voiceover without any complicated equipment or previous knowledge. And if you stick around till the end of the video, we've got something special just for you. So we've had so many requests on how to do this, but before we jump into Adobe Premiere, it's important that you look after the environment and make sure that is good first. So first of all, you want to make sure that you turn off all air conditioning units, radios in the background, close all windows, just so you don't get any traffic noise coming into the microphone as you're recording. Now, for this recording, we're using the Editor's Key Studio Series SL600 microphone, which is a broadcast USB mic. You can use any USB mic on the market, and there are some really good ones out there. So we want to make sure now that we're all plugged in and ready to go. Okay, now we've got this all set up, let's jump straight into Adobe Premiere Pro CC and show you how easily this is done. When using a USB microphone, you'll want to make sure you have it selected on your computer to ensure the audio is being recorded from that, rather than the computer's inbuilt microphone. Step one is to go to the System Preferences, then go to Sound, then Input, and make sure the USB microphone is selected. Then, within Adobe Premiere, go to Preferences, then select Audio Hardware, and make sure the microphone is selected there under Input. You can double check the setting by right clicking on the microphone and going to the VoiceOver record settings and hit this little icon here. It opens up this window, so just check that your USB microphone is selected. You can also change the countdown timer within this section here in case you need a little more time before the recording starts. So we're using our last tutorial here as an example from our Instagram, which if you haven't seen, you can check out straight after this video. As you can see, we have our edit put together in the timeline and we're ready to record our vocals. All we need to do is go to the point in our edit where we want the voiceover to start. Make sure on your timeline to create a mark in point by pressing I on your keyboard. This will be the place that your voiceover records from. If you don't see an empty audio track, you can add a new one by right-clicking here and selecting Add Audio Track. Now, all we need to do to start recording our voiceover is to hit this little microphone icon here, and as you'll see, we get a timer show up on our output window. Once the timer counts down, we can start our recording. Press stop once you're done, and voila, that's it, you've got the finished perfect take. You can now edit this file or pull it into another program like Adobe Audition to remove noise or improve the vocal. You'll find whatever you record with, you're likely to get some low-level hum from the laptop or a PC. There might also be some traffic noise in the background as well, so it's always worth cleaning this up. Okay, and that's how easily it's done. You've got your voiceover recorded. So I hope you found that useful. If you did, please leave a comment or a question in the comment section below, and I promise we'll get back to every single one. Also, don't forget to follow us on all social channels because we sometimes have exclusive content on areas such as IGTV. Don't forget to hit that subscribe, that like, and that notification bell, and then we can let you know when we're releasing new videos. And also, as promised, as a thank you for watching the video all the way through, there's a special Editor's Keys coupon in the description under this video. So make sure you check that out and you can save money off pop filters, microphones, and other great recording equipment. So check that out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.